everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Lizzie. I hope you're doing well. I'm very tired. I work for Amazon. I've said this 100 times for all my subscribers. I'm sorry. But just in case it's you're new here, I just worked a 12-hour shift. Well, 11 and a half. But I miss you guys. I miss connecting, so I wanted to give you something. We're going to call this one Christmas Message from Santa. I don't know what kind of message you're getting. I vibed out. I pulled some decks. Let's start with Theralux. I usually only use this for my deceased loved one, so we might be having a deceased loved one pop in. Sorry, I just smoked a little bit of my joint because I'm on January 1st giving up. Even though I have insomnia and I use it to sleep, I'm trying this whole super cleanse. Like, I'm hermiting out for January and February. Like, no drinking, no weedums. Not that I drink a lot. I have been smoking a lot more lately. Like, not just to sleep, because it's legal and it's like everywhere. Like, no, I'm not. I just don't want to spend money on it anymore. And it like makes me space out too much. Like, I don't want to be a stoner. I'm 38. That's not a good look. Like, come on. So I'm going to try to get myself on a sleep schedule. So, you know, until New Year's, I'm trying to get rid of whatever I did buy from the last store. They had this amazing sale. It was like buy one, get one half off. It was a Black Friday sale, by the way. And then the next day was buy two, get one free. But then they had like for special ones, special clients, they had like 30% off. So I went in for specific things and like stocked up. And I'm thinking it was going to last me, you know, freaking year, because that's when I was just doing it to sleep. Now I'm like, get home from work, I'm like, smoke a joint, because everything hurts. Nope. Nixing that. No bad habits. It's fun until New Year's and then I'm done. Just saying. Even though it's legal and it's everywhere. Just, you know, I'm trying to clear my... Oh, look at bumping my gums. I found the card. Clearing my vessels so I can channel better. I'm even going to try to give up soda. I say that every year. I always have at least one Pepsi a day. Fucking love it. I'm sorry. Plus it keeps me awake. And I drink Code Red at work just to stay awake. And I shouldn't, because that's like rocket fuel. Get into your reading. Sorry, you know I hate like wasted space. So I bump my gums while I do your cards. Your speed doesn't matter. Forward is forward. It's like you're in a rush about something. I just want to get there. Like, this person is walking too slow and it's driving me crazy. I feel like you're short-fused. Either about yourself, about something, about your family. It's that time of year, man. It's holidays. Maybe you're like me. Fucking Grinch is here. I'm like, just come on, Christmas. I wish this shit was over because I'm so done. Those are my vibes today. I'm a total Grinch this year. Even though I'm like the only one in the factory that I see wearing Christmas shit. And I'm like the grumpy Grinch. Not that I mean to anyone, like I say hi, but like I'm like the least festive. Maybe you're a Grinch like me, like this shit is taking forever. Is that your vibes? No, but for most of you it's just like I think you just want to be either further with something or you wish you did more. My ear is itching. Why? Something always itches when I'm channeling. Why is this a thing? Did anybody figure this out? I'm not the first medium that does wacky shit when they channel, you know? Why do we itch? Does anybody know? Particularly your nose. Many people who read like me always say their nose itches or their face. Why? Drives me crazy. Do any of you know? Because I'm a Virgo and not knowing is annoying. Try Googling it. Your eyes will cross. Depression lies. There is no circumstance that is unchangeable. There is no situation that is ever hopeless. Maybe you're trying to like clean yourself up, clean up a mistake. Maybe you're trying to like get someone's attention. I don't know. What is this? I'm like all of a sudden crawling out of my screen. I can't speak after these long shifts. I'm so sorry. Just suck at speaking. Sorry. Exhausted. Why is depression lying to the collective? If you watched the last reading, my ball's going like this. I can't get my... That sounds way bad. I don't have balls. Well, I do, but they're up here. In the chest region. I got cojones, you know. But not real, you know, cojones. Laugh, I feel like you need to. Why can't I get my shit together? Maybe that's where you're feeling like, why can't I just get, like, why can't I just make a decision? Why can't I just go? Why can't this just end? What is this? I need to know, Spirit, before I can give them advice. I'm a work in progress and that is okay. Okay. You're frustrated with yourself. This is about, like, you're doing well. Keep going. If you're, like, trying to be a better person, if you're trying to be more zen, if you're trying to heal childhood wounds, if you're going to therapy, if you're working on yourself, you know, if you're on a diet, whatever, you know, whatever you're doing, even if you don't see the results, Spirit is saying you're going to. Like, you're doing it. You're doing that damn thing and you're going to get there. It's not happening when you want it to. It's happening when it's meant to. Spirit's like, calm down. You're so hard on yourself. Collective. Chill. Smoke a doobie. I created it on my earth. Well, that's what I think God says. But maybe not after January 1st. I might be like, it's the devil's truck. You know. Happens to people when they quit. I'm kind of like that with cigarettes, only inside. Like, well, only in my house. I just don't want them to smoke my house. It'll trigger me to smoke. It's really not because it's annoying. You know what I'm saying? I hope I'm not like, oh my god, they're smoking way down there. Slap me, okay? Slap me straight in the face if I quit weed and I turn into those weird fucking straight edge people. Ew. But like, you need this and just put it back in my mouth and then I'll come back to myself for a second. And I'm like, wow, what a bitch. Anyway, oh my god. Stop breaking stuff. I'm really sorry. I'm not my usual self. I just wanted to channel for you. Maybe I'm not meant to know just yet everything. I'm gonna leave these. Sometimes they do that to me. They like loop it around. Let's talk about you. What's your energy with the Millennial Tarot? Learning. Endings. Going through some karma. Going through some grief, going through that dark night of the soul. The depression is lying to you. You can't overcome this. You can't achieve this. You can't get that. You can't pass that test. Like, that's your anxiety and your depression lying to you. You're doing it. Yes, you can. Don't let that depression stop you. Learn to mute it. Because let's face it, if you are born with depression and anxiety, you can't just get rid of it. But you can learn to mute it. You can learn to quiet it for a majority of the time. I feel like you're on your way to do that. Like, you are going to see the bigger picture on why everything's going down the way it is. I don't think you have full clarity at this point. You're not meant to. Clarity comes when you're healed and you're in the process of healing. You do get snippets of clarity along the way to help keep you going and help keep you on the right path, but you don't get the full perspective until you've walked the full path. Don't get ahead of yourself, is what they're saying. Anything else for your energy? Oh, hello. Oh my God, my back just cracked, but it kind of felt good. And then it kind of didn't either. My body doesn't know what to do. Oh my God. I hope I get skinny. The soul cyclist. Ooh, the star. You could be Aquarius. You could be Capricorns. Doesn't have to be. But I just feel like I said, January. Maybe it's your energy too. Maybe you're doing something for yourself or you're just focusing on something. This is what spirit wants you to do. I just got really winded where I was like, I don't know where that came from. Like, excitement, maybe it's coming for you soon. Like, you're gonna be excited. We got the festival goer popping at me. Celebrations, maybe a surprise over the Christmas season for some of you, or a surprise epiphany. It might not be like a physical surprise. It might be the aha moment that makes a decision or calms the stress. Like, oh, maybe you're gonna get a sign. And that small sign will be the one thing that makes you, and just, enjoy the holiday. Or maybe you just have a couple glasses of rum punch and you let loose over Christmas and you become the life of the frickin' party. Because that could also be that energy as well. But I just feel like for the most part, this is inner healing, working on yourself from the inside. You could have overcome a breakup or are dealing with that, or just in a very hard situation within your relationship. It doesn't have to be like we're breaking up. Maybe you're just like having money issues. Maybe your kids are, struggling with something. Like, anything can knock a couple off its path. It doesn't have to be like I want a divorce. You know what I mean? It could just be like you're having a slump, and maybe it requires you both going to your corners and just like focusing on getting anger and frustrations out. For some of you, it might be actually working out. I mean, that's where I'm headed in January. No more. I'm gonna cocoon myself. All I'm gonna do is work tarot, this channel, I mean, and work out. I'm not saying that's your thing, but I feel like you have a very minimal thing that you're focusing on and putting your energy. Either I am a more futuristic reader, so this could be coming in for you, or what you're currently dealing with now. It could be past, like current recent past, and just to help you connect with this reading, and maybe it'll link up later for current, but take what resonates to you. Don't force it, is what I'm saying. Anything else for the collective energy that we need to know with this deck, Spirit? The ghost or the moon. There's some illusions or there's some truth that I've been getting this a lot in my reading. Why are my ears itching? So weird. And my nose. I guess that's good for someone. Maybe you ghosted someone and you're regretting it. Maybe you got ghosted, or this is you putting yourself in a cocoon like me. Like, I ain't trying to like meet up with people. Like, maybe you're hermiting out. Maybe you're speaking your truth. Like, look, I need some me time. Like, I ain't trying to fight with you. I ain't trying to be a dick. But I need to ghost you for a minute and work on myself. Or maybe you're taking time from work. You're ghosting work to just, if you have the time and you need it, take it, boo-boo. You can't take that time with you when you retire. You have nothing but time. Like, take a freaking vacation. Make some memories if you can afford it, if you have time. And the festival goer popped again. I do see you having a bit of fun this holiday season, letting loose. I think it'll be helpful to this frustrated energy. But the high priestess is also seeing the truth. I think you're just trying every day to be positive and optimistic, which is all we can really do. Every day is a new start. There's going to be challenges. There's going to be successes. There's going to be moments where you want to cry, moments when you laugh. There's a zillion things that happen in one day. So why do we focus so much on days ahead? It does nothing but cause us stress. And maybe that's the point in that from spirit, is like you're maybe putting too much reference on time. Like, if I don't do this before, if I don't do this, this will happen. If I don't do this, I'm going to lose this. Like, you're putting all these rules and stress and boundaries on yourself. And I feel like it's just creating this unsettled ball of anxiety. You could be experiencing anxiety attacks for some of you. If we're going to the metaphysical cannabis oracle. I can never remember this, what it's called. Yeah. Some of you could be facing some karma, going through some judgment, or if you're not going through anything difficult, this could be you coming into the good part of karma, like you've and love, the next deck I'm going into, and signs. So maybe you've been getting a lot of signs about a love interest, but or about a love situation. Doesn't have to be, it just caught my eye that you got karma popping twice. So it could be double karma. You could be getting good karma, getting bad karma at the same time. Or like I said, you've come through the bad karma, you face the music, you learn the lesson, and now the good stuff is coming, and this is spirit rewarding you for doing the spiritual work, for not just saying you want to change, but living your change. Or this could be them referencing, if you cocoon yourself and you put that time into spirituality, or you put that time into your diet, or you put that time into your career, or whatever you're investing in, it's going to pay off for you, and they're going to help you. If you put the work in, it's kind of like, if you build it, they will come. Remember that movie? But spiritually, like, if you manifest it. If you work hard to manifest it, we will make it true. You know what I mean? That would be their saying. Alchemy, yeah. I do see a lot of manifesting for you. You might have to make some choices. You might be looking to the spiritual world to help make the decisions. Maybe you're picking between a health treatment, or what to spend your taxes on, or if you should get married or not, if you should have another kid or not, or if you should have a kid at all, if you should keep your kid. Like, I don't know. Like, there's so many, like, I just see somebody like all these life choices. It could be in the reverse. You could be seeing all the negative things, all the negative paths you went down, and you could be like, oh, all those choices. Maybe you're feeling like you wasted opportunities. Maybe you're wanting something to come back with karma in front of it. That could be maybe you didn't deserve it then, or maybe you weren't ready for it then, but you could be now. We have family. So with the holiday season coming up, this could be like coming back together. maybe you have to make some choices in how you're gonna act, how you're gonna present yourself. Like, this is Christmas vibes for some of you. I do see kind of like the peace pipe situation. Also, what goes around comes around. So for some of you going through like family drama, I feel like don't even sweat it, because As long as you're staying in the light and you're not being vindictive and you're not adding fuel to the fire, like, you're gonna come out on top. But the choices could be that aha moment that you get, the sign, like knowing what to do about a family situation, or maybe knowing what to do about proposing or getting engaged, or a family could be coworkers as well. What kind of job that you want? My throat chakra is going crazy right now. You could be having difficulty speaking your truth. Accountability. Ooh, yeah. You're facing some music. That's why I got choked up. Like, maybe you have to apologize, admit some wrongs. Maybe you have to do this in a big sense or a small sense. Maybe you're facing your family after something messed up, or you haven't seen them since a big fight. But this is like the hot seat. You're in the hot seat, either with your family or with the community about previous choices. I think you're seeing the error of your ways, and that's why you're so worried about facing the music to the people you care about. Because maybe before you didn't see you're wrong, but I feel like that's what all this is about. You're becoming a more spiritual person. You're trying to become better. You want to make up for this, but in doing that, you have to own up to it. You have to be accountable for your actions. I think you're able of to do that. I think you're willing, but you're scared. Maybe you don't know what to say or how to broach it or how it's going to go down. That could be causing the anxiety and stress. Or this is about talking about the energy you give off. When you stand in that accountability, when you sit in that hot seat, it really is all about the energy you give off. If you're sitting there and you're being defensive and you're being angry and you're being, I don't want to listen, or you be the stone face of like, yeah, so I made a mistake, arrogant, it's gonna have a negative turn of events, and you're not going to get the reaction you want. So, if you want forgiveness, you have to give off the aura of forgiveness when in the hot seat. It doesn't have to be necessarily you. It could be someone in your family. Remember, if you're on the other side of the coin, if you were other side of the coin, other side of the fence, if you were the one in the hot seat, would you want someone screaming in your face and making a big giant scene? Does that ever help? No. Like, be present of how right, wrong, and indifferent, you know, how you handle yourself, how you carry yourself, how you speak, that's on you. What aura, what energy are you putting into this? Whatever side of the fence you are on, even if you're a spectator, in the energy in the room, are you hoping for more of a feud, or are you hoping that peace will be made? Because that has an effect energetically as well. Ooh, we got miracles. Union. Justice. Wow. And create. So this is could be a lover you need to forgive or want a second chance with. This could be a twin flame thing. This could be work partners like wanting to come back. Maybe you tried to go your own way for a while and it just didn't work out, or you tried to partner with someone else and it just didn't work out. Maybe you thought the grass was greener on the other side. Again, your dream job and your dream lover are very close in readings, so unions could be both. It could be a business partner, it could be a lover, it could be a sibling, a cousin, a parent, somebody who is meant to be in your life that you're coming back to. Maybe you thought they would never forgive you, or you never thought that this would get off the ground, or you never thought this person would like you back, or you never thought they would hear you out. You have justice coming in for you. That union you want, the good one, whatever you have to face the music to, but you're dreading it. It came upright. It's going in your favor. I do see you building on a new start at the end of it here. I do see like a little bit of a hot seat moment, or it doesn't have to be a hot seat moment. It could just be a sit down, a discussion, and like clearing the air. Once that happens, you're creating, you're building something, a new start. Love, business, family. It's probably somebody you maybe haven't spoke to a while, or in a while, because you've been dreading it or you've been putting it off. You have a lot of anxiety and fear about this. Anything else from this deck? Guidance. You are getting a lot of signs. But this is also you being a guide for peace and you speaking your truth with that sword, and make sure every action you're doing, beyond what future outcome do you want and whatever that union is. Do you want peace? Do you want light? Do you want a future that's bright? Or do you want a future that's war and these angels turn black and you got swords instead of hugging each other? What outcome do you want? Project that energy. No matter who's saying what is going on, you be the high road one. You be the ruler of the room and you control the energy. Divine feminine. You could be going towards a divine feminine. It's going to go your way, I'm hearing. And blueprint. This person loves you. This is like a. My dinner's done, sorry. Unconditional love, equal give and take. They're gonna love you back. They're gonna accept you. They're gonna forgive you. Perhaps, maybe they're gonna leave other people for you, or you're gonna leave other people for them, or you're gonna be free now to, since you spoke your truth, that, oh my God, that this is your divine feminine, or you the divine feminine. Someone's coming in, could be offering you their heart in an equal sense. But now you have the freedom for a new start. The air is cleared. Healing. Healing of this complication, of this whatever you've been trying to manifest with this magic. Family member, friend, lover, whatever relationship that you haven't felt right about in a minute. We're going to the divine abundance. What do we need to know? Divine source. Yeah. Actually, let me pause it so I don't burn my dinner. Ooh, my tummy just growled so loud. It's kind of cooled down. I actually tried. They make in the store now at Walmart, they make stuffed shells and all different kinds of lasagnas, and I was like, I don't know, frozen, it's probably gonna be gross. So I bought a couple and I ate the stuffed shells one, and it was so fucking good. It's just one serving for one person. It's not like a TV dinner though. It's like you gotta cook it for an hour. It's like a real meal, like a chef makes it and freezes it, and you gotta bake it pretty much. I did the five cheese lasagna, so I hope it's good, as good as the stuffed shells was. And it's only like $4. So pretty good deal. It's healthy. I look for cheap, quick things. But oh, we have divine source and loss. I did not see the loss card. This is like the Debbie Downer card. Let me read it, what it says, because I haven't actually touched this deck in a while. It's praying. You could be praying to spirit. Hummingbirds also can signify a deceased loved one. Help me know all that my deepest needs will be met. Let me trust that you have a plan, that the right actions will come. I feel like you're praying, like, if I do this, if I risk it all, please don't let me fall on my face. Give me a sign that it's worth it. Because I feel like you're going to be having to sacrifice a lot to fly away in a new direction. Or you're realizing the loss of a person. Made you see a different meaning of life. You could have lost a family member, and how you view love and friendship and all that could have changed. And so you're changing and evolving, and not everybody can come with you. Or it could be Maybe you have experienced loss. Maybe you lost a lover. And you could be saying, is somebody coming in for me? I know I've been asking that. Like, am I gonna have babies? Am I gonna die alone? I've been asking those. Hey, I ask spirit too. I get in those moments of like, I just need a sign. Please. I feel like that's your energy. Just give me one. Ooh, change is coming. I hate change. I'm a Virgo. I don't know a Virgo that likes change at all. But you don't have to be a Virgo. Most signs do not like change. Nobody fucking likes it. Nobody likes the first day of school, like new kid vibes. Like, it's scary and the unknown. Oh my God. But we forget that the unknown can be so fucking exciting. And I have to remind myself of this a bazillion times. I'm definitely one of those people that would just hermit out the rest of their life and be totally fine. Like, I could live in the wild by myself and be fine as long as I have a YouTube channel. Like, I'm good. Feel like that's also your vibes with this barren tree. Like, thinning the herd, you know? That's happening to a lot of my friends too that are very spiritual awakened. That's surrendering. You're trying to surrender to spirit and trust them, but at the same time, you have a lot of fear. And you just want to be validated and you want to be sure. And I think spirit is validating you, but it just doesn't ever seem to be enough. I also do that too. They like literally smack me in the face with a sign, and I'm like, that was a coincidence. Do it again. And they do it again, and I'm like, do it again. And Spirit, I'm sure, is up there like, this bitch. Yep, clearing your energy, clearing the air. I think you also want to surrender to someone, like literally get down on your knees and be like, I'm sorry. I lost you. Or someone could be doing this to you. Like, I was an idiot. Please realize I'm not an idiot anymore. I don't know what the situation is, so I can't like dramatize what you would say, but I just feel like you're like, but I'm a good. I was an ass then. And we're all asses. I'm an ass at least once a day, not on purpose. Just because, you know, shit flies out of my mouth when people are freaking ignorant. I almost said stupid, but that's mean because they're not stupid. They know better. They just don't care. You know what I mean? Drives me crazy. I can't. It's like I can't focus on this reading. Again, change came up. Oh my God. Karma came up again. Reframe. Karma happened or is happening so that you would see the truth and maybe see some other love interest as the gift. Like, spirit could be like, oh my God, you're with this jerk. Look at my angel over here for you that I've put in your path. Ah. You know what I mean? Like, why need you over here to see the and you're focused on the womp womp. So they had to shake your snow globe until the snow cleared and you were like, oh, and spirit's like, oh, finally. Maybe the change is you've changed your mind. Maybe you're going back for someone. Maybe someone's coming back for you. Unfinished business is definitely in the air. I don't know what kind, still. Let's close it out with your La Luna Sol Tara. Tara. Tarot. Maybe your name's Tara. I just heard, like, saw Tara from True Blood when I said that. Crazy, right? That was a long time ago. Seen that show in a minute. If you watch it now, I'm sure it's probably like cheesy and stuff. Eight of Cups. Moving on from something. That grass is greener energy. I think you're about to go find out if it is. Or maybe someone left you behind. That could be feeling a little bit like a victim as well. But just see you hermiting out, swimming away to your private island to do it, to do your damn thing. Or you know what you want. You're willing to sacrifice it all to go to that grass is greener on the other side. Towards a high priest or somebody you feel a connection to, or you're seeing the truth about something. Maybe I just need to push everybody out and have some me time. Or getting those signs that you've been asking for, getting that clarity from spirit. But do you see that yin and yang symbol that also talks about twin flames? The balance. Opposites attract. Light and dark. We're both equal parts light and dark. So we all mess up and we're all part and we all do good. Like, it'll flip the script a million times in your life. Don't harp on it too much. Harp on it when you're doing the good stuff. Enjoy that. Just learn the lesson from the bad stuff and move on. It's annoying, I know, but that's the best thing to do. Three of Wands, you could be waiting for something to come in. Could be waiting on some money. Could be waiting on a sign. Could be waiting on news. You could be waiting for something to end. You could be waiting for your application to be read. You could be waiting for Christmas. I don't know. Waiting, but that energy of comes back. You're impatient. You're sick of waiting. You want to fly like the birds. But there's some kind of exchange that you're waiting. It could be an exchange of money, exchange of feelings, signing of things. It could also be weighing your options. You could be just sitting there weighing your options, not making a decision. Just taking a holiday like the birds. Like, I'll make a decision after Christmas. Let's talk about current energy. What's good currently? Three of Swords, Queen of Cups, Wheel of Fortune, Four of Wands. So you're heartbroken, or this is a third party situation. Queen of Cups is somebody very nurturing, very loving. Somebody you're very sexually attracted to, passionate about, warm, beautiful, sweet. Wheel of Fortune to me is wanting to either get out of a third party to be with this Queen of Cups, or this Queen of Cups is the one that broke your heart. And Four of Wands is like happy and stable, but with the Wheel of Fortune, like, that could have been beforehand, but it came upright. So I feel like majority of you want to leave, either being single to settle down with a Queen of Cups energy, masculine, feminine, doesn't matter. Like I said, this is someone who will offer you a stable cup of love, who's practical, sweet, kind, loving, nurturing, patient, beautiful inside and out when it's upright. I think your heart is broken. Either maybe you feel you lost this Queen of Cups, but you want to get them back. You want to fix it because you see a stable life, a family with them, or maybe you have a family and you want to keep this going, like keep it alive. Or this Wheel of Fortune, Four of Wands could be a proposal at Christmas around the tree. I'm getting those vibes. Or you're getting married soon for some of you, but you had to go through heartache to get to this Queen of Cups. But I will clarify. Let's clarify with this Three of Swords. What's this heartbreak? Or it could be stabbed in the back energy. Nine of Cups. Something is a wish fulfillment, but it breaks your heart at the same time. Why does it break your heart? Why is there pain here? Judgment. Ah, this is the karma. You're seeing the truth for someone. Maybe you picked the wrong person, or you didn't treat him right. Maybe you lost this person. They're your wish for. You're the one that. I'm sorry. They're the one that you want, whatever way. I don't believe in coincidences, but you want this person. I don't know if you always did, but it's like breaking your heart. Either to be away from them or to realize you've lost them. Tell me more. What is this judgment about? Ace of Cups. So some of you have to end something and are currently doing that so that you can come make an offer here to this Queen of Cups. And some of you maybe this it broke your heart that you never told someone how you felt about them. Maybe you feel you missed an opportunity. What's this Queen of Cups? The World, Knight of Swords, King of Discs. This is someone you literally see as your world, like the light of your life, the love of your life for some of you, best friend, somebody you would die for. You want to come in and speak some truth about your feelings. Or come in and ask for their forgiveness. But you want to be practical and stable, and you want to offer them something practical. The King of Discs, Queen of Cups. Very emotional meets practicality. Like the nurturer and the provider. They just want to be able to love you, and you just want to take care of them, or vice versa. What's this Wheel of Fortune? Seven of Wands. There's some adversity you like karmics or just life in general. Could be distance, could be obligations, but there's reasons why you're not with this Queen of Cups, why you're not coming. This could be your anxiety and your fears, fighting yourself. Tell me more. Yeah, weighing, you need to make a choice either between two people or if it's worth it, if you can live with never speaking your truth or never asking forgiveness. What's this Four of Wands? Again, if it's not you asking for forgiveness, this is someone wanting to ask forgiveness for you or to you. Page of Discs. You wanna start new. If you already have a family, this could be like blended families coming together. This could be someone a little younger or just has youthful energy. If you're pregnant, you could be having a boy. That's very specific. I heard the birth will be fine. Don't worry. Hey. Stop scratching my couch, Loony. This is a new start or a new beginning. Again, if you're not leaving, like this is the happiness coming back into the family. This is you guys making up. Or being like kids again over the holiday. Or just putting the kids first. The Hermit. There is reflection. Maybe wanting to be alone with someone. Knight of Wands. Reflecting on your actions and maybe reflecting on a plan on how to come in and ask for this person's forgiveness. How to let them see what they mean to you or what you mean to this person if it's not you. They're never really specific, so I have to say it both ways. Seven of Swords. The one that got away energy for some of you. Like, oh, the one I shouldn't have left behind. You're going back for. Get two more and close it out. Anything else we need to know about the future? Five of Swords. It's going to be a hard fight, a battle to get this thing that you want, but I don't feel like it's a battle between like a love interest or the good business partner or the family member you're making amends with. It's like outside karmics or outside situations, but I do see you being victorious in the back there to hell or high water. But it's not going to be easy. It's going to be very difficult. Nine of Wands and King of Wands. I think you're going to be very defensive of, or very protective of this new start. You're going forward with passion and you're not allowing any negativity or anyone to get in the way of this, especially if you're coming back together and making amends. Six of Wands, recognition, victory. This is the victory card. It also is a public display of affection card. Got the wreath popping about Christmas. If you're the one that want, I just do something for Christmas is what I heard. I don't know what that means. The star. So you could be Aquarius. Let me see what all the signs are. The tower. Healing. It's happening after a tower or happened because of a tower. The tower could be a big thing, or it could just be the aha. I'm not sure what kind of tower you're having. I think it's an emotional one with this Nine of Swords, anxiety, Three of Discs about third party situation, about time. This eye is popping. You could be watching someone from afar and feeling like you're missing out. Getting a, quite a few things. We have Aries, Leo, and Sag. Aquarius. Virgo. Taurus, Capricorn. Pisces, Cancer. More earth, water, Scorpio, air, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Everybody's here. Everybody's here. It could be anything. I thought the signs might help you. Ooh, devil on the bottom of the deck. Remember, devil is just the ending and the beginning. So again, referencing something's closing out and something's coming in for you. Don't let the anxiety lie to you because I feel like something's going to be really fruitful for you. I think they gave you a sign about that. But right now, it's focusing on getting your freedom. Trust the divine. And right now, something about Christmas will click with you. Allow. Be spontaneous, is what I heard. Have courage. Have faith that you're going to either be enough or you're going to do well. This comes from your inner childhood wounds of not feeling good enough or second best. This person is your match. Or this business partner is your, it's your thing. Like it's meant for you. It's gonna work out. Take a deep breath. I'm feeling your anxiety. My ticker's. Anyway, I'm gonna go eat and go to bed. I love you guys so much. I'm sorry I'm all over the place, but one more week. It's been a long month. I've been grinding for a month. On Friday morning at 6:15, I would have been grinding like hell week for 4 weeks straight. I'm tired. My body hurts. I can't even open my eyeballs all the way. And it's not even because of the weed. Like, I wish I could say it was from weed and not exhaustion. Maybe Amazon is the cure for insomnia. Wouldn't that be some shit? Anyway, I love you. Please like this, subscribe, share. I forgot to say that. So bad at promoting myself. I love you. See you next time. I don't know when, but I'll see you soon. Happy holidays, everyone. Toodles!